Oh, perfect, yes. I've been looking for this look.
Alright. Yeah, I like that.
Keep going. Harder.
What? Oh my goodness!
Okay,
so
yeah.
We're here in Gemünden.
Yeah,
And this is Krista and Megan, and we're going to be doing some chemistry here by the side of the lake.
Yeah.
And can you tell me what you've got in front of you?
Yeah, I can. A beaker with hot water and some flasks.
Okay, we've got some flasks. They've got some numbers. They've got some numbers on them, yeah?
Yes, they do. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so very simple. At the moment, the temperature on this one you can see here is about sort of 50 degrees.
Yeah.
Okay, so we want it somewhere between 40 and 50. It doesn't really matter too much. It'll be in the right sort of area.
Okay.
Okay, so Megan, we'll start off with number one. I just want to pour flask number one into the into this flask for me here.
Okay.
Nothing's going to hurt you, honestly, I promise.
Slowly.
It's all right, just check in.
Okay, blue. Ooh, pretty.
Okay, so what we've got in there is a dye. It's the same dye that you, well, a very similar dye that you use to dye jeans.
Okay.
And it's indigo dye, or it's been slightly adapted to help it to bind to more like wool and natural non-cellulose-based fibres.
Okay.
Okay, and it gives us this really nice blue colour, and we're going to be having a look at some of the colours that we can get from this dye.
Okay.
So next thing we're going to do is we're going to chuck in the second flask here. That's right, you can get rid of the thermometer now.
Okay, put it
in
here?
Yeah, go for it.
Why should we put the
lid? That's okay,
all of it?
Yeah, check it in.
Green.
Okay, so it's gone green there. Okay,
yeah.
We'll give it
a
swirl there. We got a nice green colour.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, and then last one, number three. In it goes. And it's kind of stayed green.
Yeah.
Slightly, maybe a slightly different green.
Yeah.
And it's definitely, we've got sort of like an emerald green going on there, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we're going to give that a couple of seconds.
Brown.
Red?
Red.
It's a red. Oh my goodness. Check it.
Okay, I didn't even have to pay for that response. Thank you, Krista. Okay, so it's
now
red.
Now we're going to orange.
Wow, okay.
Okay, orange, yep. And now finally,
yellow.
Yeah, okay. So what do you think is going to happen if you shake that?
If I shake it?
Yeah, like a Polaroid picture, yo.
I think it's gonna clear.
Okay, give it a try. Keep going. Harder.
What? Oh my goodness!
Oh.
Okay, try and keep the stopper in here.
Oh, sorry. It's like,
so what's happened?
Keep going? It's turning back to all the different colors. And now it's going back.
It'll go back to red.
To red.
And then...
And
orange.
Then orange, and then yellow. Should I shake it again?
Yeah, go for it. Carries on doing the same thing.
Okay. I think I'm making quite a mess here. Still red. We're not shaking hard enough.
Shake harder.
Ooh. You didn't get that then. Whoa!
There you go.
Wow.
So what do you think's causing that?
You have a kind Ahnu.
Well, what's in here that potentially you could be adding to the solution that could be involved in some kind of chemistry?
Oxygen.
Yeah. Okay, it's an oxidation reaction.
Okay.
Okay, and then what we added there, the last thing we added some glucose, which gets rid of the oxygen again. We won't do that too hard.
Okay.
Okay, and it carries on doing that for like sort of 45 minutes or so.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
And you keep going doing that. Now I've got a slightly different version of this.
Okay.
Right, okay, so we've just seen what happens with this flask here. You give it one shake, it goes red. Two shakes, it goes green.
Okay.
Okay, and comes back again. Now, the green colour that we're seeing there is actually not a pure chemical. It's a mixture of two different forms of the indigo dye. The normal blue dye that you would use to dye your clothes with.
Yeah.
And at high pH, so in an alkaline environment, it exists as a yellow form.
Okay.
So the green thing that we're seeing is like a mixture of the blue and the yellow, which makes green.
We can do
that, okay? Yeah. So what we want to try and aim for this time is we're going to make up a similar material or a similar mixture. And this time, our mixture, we're going to try and aim for like the blue end of things. Okay, so we're going to add a little bit of some sodium hydroxide here, which is going to increase the pH, but we don't want it to go so far that it's completely into green.
Okay,
so slightly more complicated, but it's going to give us a slightly different range of colours.
Okay.
So, we're going to grab off this one. This one's got a little bit more water in to start off with. And, Krista, what I want you to do is drop by drop, add some sodium hydroxide into here after we've added our dye.
Okay.
So we're going to have our dye. It starts off blue again. We want to add it so we're on the sort of verge of going green, but not quite there.
Okay.
Still definitely blue. Definitely blue. Megan, you're watching. I don't want this going green.
I can't see your hands in the way.
Okay, it's definitely blue, isn't it?
Still blue,
Is there a hint of green? I'm gonna,
one here? Yeah,
there
is a hint.
There was just a hint there.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think we're sort of close on that border. So we're starting off like with a blue kind of colour.
Okay,
we're going to get the sodium hydroxide out of the way.
Okay.
Okay, you can put that back in. So this time we're starting off something that's it's probably not coming out very well on the camera. You can just about see it's still blue.
Yeah.
There's like a hint of green there. We're going to add in the third mixture. This is actually glucose we're adding. What do you think is going to happen with the colours this time? So we started off, we finished yellow, and we started off green. This time we're starting blue.
Yellow.
And we went through red.
Uh-huh. And orange.
Question is how well it's going to show up.
There you go, it's going. It's red-ish.
If it works, in theory, it should go. Because you remember we had the red medium form here.
Yeah.
The red and the blue, of course, makes purple. So
yeah.
It goes from blue to purple, and then through to red, and then to the orange, and then to the yellow.
Okay.
So you get a different range of colours. But because it's really dark, it may not be that convincing that it's going to go. I may have to do this one back in the lab. Oh, it's kind of going. Oh, it's going
purple. It's purple. For sure purple.
Okay, there we go. It's just, I think it's because we've been out here for a few minutes. It's just cooled down a little bit. Okay, it's going through purple.
It's pretty. It's like violet.
Yeah,
that's
okay.
Lovely.
There you go.
All right, now we're through to
now
the
it's turning red.
Sort of like a ruby.
Yeah. Oh.
Through to the red. Come on.
Give us
yellow.
It's cooperating now. Pretty.
It does sort of warm up a bit after the sort of first 15 minutes, but we don't want to sit here for 15 minutes. So. Okay, so we'll see if we can get it go back. It's kind of, going on the yellow side.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it goes back to blue. Blue, purple.
Yeah.
Back to red. There we go.
Eventually, you should
go back to the yellow. Right. Thank you so much, guys, for getting involved.
Thank you, Declan.
Did you enjoy that?
I enjoyed it very much,
That's the main thing. All right. Back to the lab, I think.
Okay, sounds good.